Like, if you look at Cuban community as a whole, it's always better to just aim for the general part of it, not just like the female thing. So that
Yeah,
is what is
definitely.
motivating me right now. But like, for the female scene, I would definitely, definitely want more females to be to join.
Welcome back to Twisting with Cubers Season 2. And since this is COVID era, so we are recording from our home. And today we have Avni Sood with us. Avni, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thanks for having me. Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm great. Just COVID is not stopping. Before jumping into your cubing life, I want to ask, like, how was your COVID like, how is the situation there, and how you're coping with it, and how's everything going?
Everything's going good. Well, COVID was already not really great, not for anyone, I guess. Especially in cubing terms, competitions were missed a lot. And थोड़ी मोटिवेशन कम हो गई थी क्यूबिंग के लिए, सो दैट हैपेंड एंड इट्स गोइंग वेल आई गेस. या
And when was the like the first motivation came for cubing? Like, how did you got introduced to cubing?
सो व्हेन आई वाज इन फर्स्ट और सेकंड स्टैंडर्ड, आई वाज गोइंग इन माय स्कूल बस एंड एट द बैक सीनियर्स, वन ऑफ माय सीनियर्स वाज सॉल्विंग द क्यूब एंड आई वाज लाइक वाओ दैट सीम्स इंटरेस्टिंग. बट आई हैड अ क्यूब, यू नो ट्रिप पे जाते हैं यू गेट अ क्यूब जस्ट लाइक एज अ टॉय, सो आई हैड वन ऑफ दोज एंड आई हैड एक्सपेरिमेंटेड विद इट थोड़ा बहुत. मम्मी कभी कभी लाइक शी डू वन और टू टर्न्स एंड देन आई ट्राई टू सॉल्व इट एंड देन वंस वी वेंट टू फार एंड इट वॉज क्रम्बल्ड. सो इन लाइक सेकेंड ग्रेड आई सॉ वन ऑफ माई सीनियर्स एंड आई वॉज लाइक ओके यू नो वट आई कैन डू दिस टू, बट आई डेंट हैव एनी रिसोर्सेज. सो वन ऑफ माई फ्रेंड केम ओवर and she solved the cube in front of me and I was like wow you can do that, that's really great. So I was like okay where did you learn? So she's like YouTube. So that was the first time I was like okay you can do something like this also. So I learned from YouTube at that time in like 2012 2013 types, and then around 2017 I got back into it over so our midterms had just finished, I was in sixth grade. And after that, I had holidays, so I was like, okay, what do I do? So I got into cubing that time.
And
this, yeah, so Speed
yeah,
Cubing
so
Bangalore had a stall here in our apartment. So yeah, that's how I got introduced to it for the second time, basically.
and how has been like cubing in like what is the role of cubing so far in your life?
It's played quite a big of a role. I mean, it's like one of my favorite things ever. Like, it just feels like home to me, I guess. I enjoy it a lot, and you know, traveling for competitions, just the prospect of looking forward to a competition, it's just very enjoyable for me mostly.
And what are your current records, and what are the things that you're proud of in your cubing journey so far?
So the first thing that I was really, really, really proud of was my female national record at Indian Nats 19. I mean, I know it's not like a very huge thing in terms of cubing, like there's so many greater people, but for me that was always a goal. So in 2018 I attended a competition and that's where I got introduced to the whole female scene in cubing, and there was not a lot of it, so I was like okay, you know what, this is something I can achieve, it's not too hard. It was just like a short-term goal. So when at Nats 2019, when I got that national record certificate, I was like very, very, very proud of that.
And
Yeah.
what was the rea and what was the reaction of your parents back then when you got that certificate?
So they were very happy. So my mom had actually taken me, and so I contacted my dad after the competition, and everyone just went crazy. They were like, "Wow!" types. I mean, they knew I'd been hoping to achieve this for a while, but they were very, very happy. Yeah.
And what are your current goals? Like, what are you aiming right now? Like, you have broken that female national record, right? So what are your goals right now?
Right now, it's a sub-10 average once competitions open up, and possibly top 10 in the world for female and top 100 normally. And more like, I have more of like competition goals, like getting to like getting in the finals of Asians for Mega Minx. I have more goals towards Mega Minx right now. Yeah.
What are you go like? What is your average right now in Mega Minx?
Right now, I average around 51 seconds.
Oh, that's amazing. I have been actually trying myself like megaming for some time now, but not that fast.
Right.
Like, what are your like? Do you have an? What are the other things that you enjoy apart from cubing? Like your hobbies, or is it like?
Well, for a very long time, like cubing has been my main hobby. I mean, there's not a lot of things I do apart from it. Except like right now, I'm a little bit into article writing sometimes. Rarely types, but yeah, that's the only thing apart from cube.
And what do you do? Like, are you in school? Are you in college?
I'm 14 years old and currently in 9th grade as of 2021.
Okay, yeah. That's so amazing. And is it, I want to ask about like the female scene, like as you mentioned, you discovered in 2017 or 18, if I'm not wrong. And so what do you think about why there are so handful of female cubers in the community, even if you talk about on a like a broader level, in like on a global scale, and especially, and if you narrow down it to India, there are like a very, very few. So why you think so, where there are like so many less female cubers?
Well, firstly, there's the whole stereotypical thing. Mm-hmm. I mean, boys will be interested in gaming and girls will be interested in fashion and all that stuff. Of course, right now it's reduced so much more, but mm-hmm. that is still a thing in many societies. So that has always been a thing. Apart from that, just the fact that there are already not enough girls in the cubing community doesn't really help the fact when like someone else tries and joins. So in 2018, when I actually got kind of serious into cubing, I went to a comp. So there were two comps in April or something. So the first comp I went to, I talked to one girl and she was the only girl there. And I was like, okay, you know what? This doesn't seem like a lot of fun, because me as a person, I don't really go and talk to a lot of people. So, I mean, and they were all boys and I mean, older than me too. So I was like, okay, I wasn't too keen on going and talking to them. The girls, sure, but yeah, that didn't help. But then in the second competition, there was the fastest female category. And I got that and I was like, okay, you know what, there's some chance here. So that's what motivated me more. So probably just like motivating more and, you know, having more girls already, that definitely helps.
And like, what is the current state of mind, in the sense that there are still very few female cubers? Is that like motivates you more that you can be like one of best of the best in the on a global level also? Or is it like a demotivating again, there are like so less cuber, female cubers, and you don't have so much to connect or share with?
I mean, it's always, I mean, like if you look at cubing community as a whole, it's always better to just aim for the general part of it, not just like the female thing. So that is what is motivating me right now. But like, for the female scene, I would definitely want more females to be to join. There are too few females here. I mean, at a comp of like 100 people, you'll have like what, 5-6 max?
Yeah,
definitely. To most comps I've been at. And doesn't really motivate more girls either. So it'll be definitely more helpful to make it more friendly for girls. Yeah.
And do you try to like teach your female friends about cubing, or like teach them a basic 3x3? What is the reaction?
They're not very interested.
I mean, it's like, if you connect, you connect. If you don't, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
All right. I want to come back to Cube Lelo. And I want to ask what role Cube Lelo has played in your journey, in the cubing journey, and what do you think is there a role on a national level they are playing to support this cubing?
Cube Lelo is doing a very, very good job. I mean, of course there's Cube Nama as well, but Cube Lelo is just like taking it onto another level, especially in India. And it's great how many, like the variety of puzzles they have and stuff. It's very motivating when they actually sponsor competitions and stuff as well. That was definitely a motivating factor for me as well. Like, just like, you know, getting prizes at comps, that's obviously a huge factor for everyone. So it's really good how much they're motivating people, especially with the sponsorships and stuff. That was also a very big factor for me, just like the prospect of getting sponsored. So, I mean, they're doing a very, very, very good job and I'm super grateful to them.
And have you attended the Cube Lelo Speed Cubing Unlimited that happened during the lockdown?
Yeah, the speed cubing unlocked. Yeah, I did. I attended one, like around 2 to 3 out of the 8, 9 of them. Online competitions really weren't my thing that much. So, yeah, but.
But I think it helped like most of the cubers to just be stay connected in those like
Yeah,
so uncertain
exactly.
times.
Yeah.
Even if I know it's difficult, like nothing can replace the offline competitions, right? But still,
Obviously.
they have that, you know, just a bit that platform that you can still be connected to the cubing and maybe not lose that motivation that you were talking about
Yeah.
earlier.
So like a lot of newer cubers who haven't been to WCA competitions, a lot of them have been to online competitions and they're really motivated by that. So it's really great how they try to keep up the whole competition scene. Like Cubeler did done like a fantastic job, yeah.
Exactly, I second that. And what are your like future plans on cubing? Like, do you like and how do you see cubing playing a major part, keep playing a major part in your life?
So I'm like hoping to go to the Red Bull Championships once I'm old enough and I can go. I really like the Red Bull female scene. I mean, it's a very big motivating for all females because they also have a separate category. So that's really really cool. That is something I look forward to, and just going to World Championships, that's been my dream for the longest time. So yeah.
I hope you achieve all your dreams. And before I move to like the questions asked on Instagram and some other social channels, can you do a walkthrough solve of maybe a 3x3 or a Mega Minx or whatever you feel?
Sure, yeah, I'll do 3x3. Okay. Just like.
I can learn something.
Yeah, okay. So, well, walk through as in just like what I'm doing in the salt types?
I mean, just showing your pro like how your thought process, a basic thought process, how do you go about
Ah,
solving?
okay, right. So, here, this is a pretty easy scramble, and the cross is like 5, 6 moves. So since it's an easy cross, I'll probably look for another pair or like either a corner or something while I'm doing the cross. I'm not very much into inspecting the first pair first, but yeah. So I'll start off with the cross, and I automatically see this pair here, so I'll solve the first pair. And while I'm doing that, I'll look for another one. So I saw one pair there and one pair solved here, so I'll just solve that. And the last pair. And while I'm doing that, I'll start looking ahead into my OLL. And then again, while I'm doing that, I'll look ahead into PLL. And yeah, pretty much it. I still use the
So,
wild, yeah, nasty wild,
what
yeah.
what are like some of the tips and tricks or like mindset that you can teach to the beginners who are starting or who are like really trying to improve? What are the resources or mindset or like some tips they can use to improve?
Well, one thing is follow the cubing community on YouTube. There are a lot of tutorials, a lot of things that can help you. Sometimes it might be effective to find a coach near you. I know Kunal Oak and all, they're doing a lot of critiques and stuff. So that can obviously help you much, and that would be better, I think, at like a sub 20 level. But at any speed, if you need any help, reach out to any fast cubers. That's like a very important thing. Reach out to people, don't be afraid to ask questions. Yeah, and learn as much as you can. So a mindset thing could be just, you know, not caring about anything. I usually put on like loud music and just sit and do a session for a while. Just like don't think, basically.
How long do you practice these days?
right now with 9th grade, not much. I mean, like the past few months, not much. But back when COVID wasn't a thing, I would practice around 1, 1.5, 2 hours types. Yeah.
Okay, and you talked about taking coaching and getting help from the community. Are there any specific people that really helped in your journey?
Well, there was Vivek Prasad Mada, Mr. Vivek sir, and Vikram sir from Speed Cubing Bangalore. They helped me a lot, especially when I was starting out back in like 2018 types. Yeah, mostly them. A lot of other people have helped me too.
So yeah, you're talking about being in the ninth standard. So how are you trying to manage, and what is your like parents' opinion that you are now in 9th standard, so you also focus on like what is their reaction? Because I'll tell you mine, what happened in my 9th grade and what. So how do you managing studies and cubing, and what is your parents' opinion right now? Has it changed?
Yeah, it has changed significantly. So like, in 7th grade, when I started out, they were like, "Kuch karna to hai nahi isne." Kuch nahi hona, it's just like one of a phase. So I've had a lot of phases like that. I had a basketball phase, I had a tennis phase. I've had phases for everything. And they were like, "Pakka ye bhi like 2-3 mahine mein khatam ho jayega. So don't invest too much into this." But then 7th grade, 8th grade, it got better. 8th grade, when I got the NR, my parents were really proud of that, and then they're like, okay, kuch ho sakta hai yahan pe. So when I was in 7th grade, my mom was like, tu 9th or 9th ka tab bhi theek hai, 10th mein chhod diyo. But now she's okay with it. She's like, okay, do it, but I mean 10th is important. So she's like, okay, I know you love it, focus on it as well, but don't, you know, disregard studies totally. Yeah,
I mean, my parents advised me the same thing, and not really parents, I actually thought that I really want to focus on my studies, so I actually left for like 3 or 4 years.
Uh-huh.
And I believe that was like one of the biggest mistakes that I made, because I mean, like, studies are important, but you can easily manage like even half an hour a day. You just be in touch with, like, even if you don't improve, even if you don't attend competitions, just be in the touch, like at the level that you are right now. Otherwise, if you leave it, it gets so hard to get back up again, and, you know, even to come back to the same averages that you are having right now.
Yeah,
so my suggestion is just like, even if you don't attend competitions, if you don't drill so many ALS, just don't leave that part out of,
yeah,
you know,
definitely
trying. Definitely. So awesome. So I have a few questions from audience, and you can answer in a few words, or you can answer like however you feel. So it's by Jay. Can you beat Juliet Sebastian in future?
I want to, sure. But she's very, very fast. It'll take me a while to get there.
But yeah, you'll get there. What was your first competition, and when was it?
I think it was Indian Cubing Challenge, October or November 2017.
Awesome. Are you color neutral?
No, I'm dual neutral, but in rare conditions, mostly white cross only.
You're 2x2 PB.
2x2. I don't really do 2x2. I just got a lucky scramble once at home, which is like 0 point something. In comp, it's like 3 seconds, 3.xx. I don't even know. I don't do 2x2.
I think I also got a lucky solve on an official comp. I think it was 3, but yeah, that was super
lucky.
Yeah,
3 is like very slow compared to like India's cubing 2x2 scene.
Yeah. But for me, it was good enough.
Exactly, same.
Okay, I just learned advanced cross and F2L. What should I focus next? Full OLL or PLL?
Definitely on full PLL first. It's easier. It'll keep you more motivated. Then move on to full OLL, yeah.
Awesome. Tips for beginners?
Beginners, like there's like a lot of different types of beginners. So.
Give some advice on Megaminx, I think. That would be a good way.
Huh, sure. So, Megaminx is actually, you just need to get the hang of it. It's like any, not even big cube, it's like any event basically. You need to get the hang of it for a while. Basically, once you cross like a 2 minute or 2 minute barrier, the 2 minute barrier is like a lot of people are afraid of. Once you cross that, it's actually pretty easy to get faster. Felix Zemdeg, Cube Skills website, that's where I learned. It's basically the best website out there. Don't be afraid to practice. So just practice, and you'll very easily get to sub 2. Then you can start looking into more tutorials and walkthroughs and stuff.
And you have improved also like from the Felix website?
Yeah, like I've basically done only Cube Skills. especially back when I was starting out for Megaminx, not 3x3. 3x3 is a lot of YouTubers, but you don't have a lot of content on Megaminx on YouTube. I mean,
yeah, definitely. And I think that is true for every puzzle. I think you just have to put your mindset on it, and you can easily improve. So, in just closing, do you have any final words, or like anything that you want to advise the upcoming cubers or anything you want to say about the cubing community, like all yours.
Well, cubing community is amazing, amazing. I'm so grateful to have found this community. To female cubers, don't be afraid to come. Please go to more competitions. The cubing scene is getting bigger for females. It'll get better, yeah. And Cubelello is doing an amazing, like, fantastic job. So really grateful to them for that. Yeah, that's it.
I wish you all the best for all the things that you're aiming for your studies, for your cubing careers and everything else. And thank you so much for taking time. And I hope you have a great day and a great year. Thank you.
Thanks to you guys, yeah.
Yeah, so when I started cubing, I didn't have really a goal to break the national record. But like as soon as I started getting into it, I realized that I'm having this potential to become faster.